Hey everybody, welcome to Not Sorry Love Lori. I'm Lori and this is Abrar, my
partner.
Guys,
how's it going?
And we are gonna do a Q&A. The questions came from you guys. Okay, so first, why don't you subscribe and like and leave us a comment down below. Let us know what you think of this video. Let's get started. Okay, question number one. How long have you been together?
Almost 3 years, I think.
Or like two and a half.
Yeah.
It doesn't feel like it's
time
been
is
long.
An illusion anyway. I had a friend who used to say that, but then we get frustrated when you need to get up for work on time.
Who is the more serious one and who is the most fun?
I'm definitely more serious.
One. Definitely the more serious one. I goof around. Who is the better cook?
I would say it's debatable, but definitely you. Because I know how to cook two things. Only two things.
More than two things. There's like 10, probably.
But you're definitely the better cook.
I don't know.
What do you think?
I think I have more time that I spend cooking, and I experiment more, but I don't know if that makes me better. Because you're like an expert at what you cook.
But you know flavor profiles and stuff. Because I can't do quizzes with my food.
Oh, the food quizzes? Yeah, check out my Instagram. Yeah, I do food quizzes and yeah, they're fun. But thank you for what you just said. How did you meet?
It was Bumble.
Dating app.
Yeah. I like Bumble more just because it allows the women to initiate the conversation instead of, because you know, like maybe you want to explain that a little bit.
Yeah, just quickly. So like for a lot of women on dating apps, they get bombarded with like a lot of messages from men. And with Bumble, you have the opportunity, if you guys match, then the woman has the opportunity to send them a message and there's 2 or 3 days or whatever, it will expire and your match no longer exists anymore.
Which is what happened to me because I think I got busy and then I didn't reply in time and then I lost
sure.
it. Yeah. And then, so then I, there's an option where obviously Bumble is an app, like they want to make some money too. So they're like, well, if you pay like a certain amount of money, you can still reinitiate the conversation, and I did, and I think that was the best decision that I had made in about 30 years. That's true.
And then we started talking, and then from then on, it was just like,
yeah, I can't.
I want to know more about you, and I want to spend time with you.
And that was it. Yeah, I don't even remember the path in between.
Once we met, we were just like, okay, this is kind of.
This is it.
I was at such a low point in my life and he was the first person that I was like, I'm just gonna be super honest with, and just like, we spoke for the first time and he's like, how are you? I'm like, I feel like shit. I'm coming off of, you know, substances and my life is turning inside out, and he...
I just said, okay.
He's like, okay, well...
Let's take it from there.
Yeah, take it 1 hour at a time and... But yeah.
That's all you can do.
Does Abrar also have substance abuse issues? And does that make it difficult for Lori's recovery?
No, I do smoke. So kind of working on that.
Cigarettes,
yeah. I'm kind of trying to work on that a little bit. It's a bit of a struggle, as people know. But otherwise,
serious addiction.
Yeah, it's the most, because it's socially accepted, right? So it's very hard to get rid of that because the consequences aren't as grave in the short term. Mm-hmm. It's more of a long-term thing, so you don't have to think about it.
And the cravings are real. Like, yeah, the withdrawal is terrible.
You can't, you want to eat more and stuff. But no, otherwise, no, I don't, which I think makes it actually easier to maintain, an environment that's conducive to somebody who's looking to recover, I think.
Yeah, no, I think if Abrar had like serious substance abuse issues that were also like really negatively affecting his life, it would make it so difficult, I think, for us to do that and focus on sobriety and my harm reduction strategies, and like, it's so complicated for each person that if you know, you had that complexity to you, it would have
be very difficult.
So he's kind of like in more balanced state than I am in a lot of ways.
It's a good question.
I bring him out of his like comfort zone a little bit.
Exactly.
And with fun and excitement. And you helped me to sort of like stabilize a little bit
quite
and kind
a
of like
structure.
Yeah, sure. And routine. And,
life is all about balance, so I think that's why we can jive.
How did your families react to being different religions?
Yeah, it wasn't really like a surprise or anything like that.
For my family, like, I had never dated someone that came from a Muslim family or was Muslim. I had dated people of like Christian faith. I think some people were a little shocked, but most of my family is like very open and accepting, and you met some of my family. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think some people in my family were a little like curious and baffled because Jews and Muslims have that stereotype of like hating each other. People do not think Muslims and Jews are going to work well together.
Like Jews and Muslims is similar to like Pakistanis and Indians, where we're supposed to, there's a lot of, you know, not hatred, but it's a lot of like
animosity. There are stereotypes, but you have to get to know the individual because it doesn't mean that everybody's that way.
Exactly.
What kind of reactions do you get from people being an interracial couple?
People sometimes will have questions, but they're mostly, I think people are trying to figure out what the cultural clash is between the East and the West. We do get looks where, not really though, this is Canada. I think if you were somewhere else, maybe.
We wonder if they're looks. We don't really know, because sometimes we sort of get scowls from people, or they'll look at us and they might be sort of baffled.
From like, older people though, we get scowls from older people that are like when you're shopping or whatever like that, but generally, but we did have one person, I think, I remember,
so nice.
It was so nice. Yeah. He was like, oh, you guys look good together.
We were
nice
just like, aw, while we were trying to do our groceries.
I was trying to get my groceries in the car.
Those are always nice and welcome. What does a regular day look like for you? So, I sleep until 11.
But you do need your sleep.
I do need sleep. It's a big part of my recovery.
When you've been on the go for a long time like you have, like you need to sleep. I can get up early and kind of do some work, hang out with Butters. But yeah, that's pretty much it. And then because I work from home, so we can kind of hang out. So, work, hanging out, TV, Butters, walks.
Like I'm home. And like a lot of the therapy, well, all the therapy that I do is online.
Pretty fortunate to be able to do that, right? In this,
and then be able to go and like take a nap if you want or whatever. Like, luckily it's like a little bit flexible in that way.
Mm-hmm.
And then I like to cook sometimes, so maybe I'll spend like a couple hours cooking. I've been going live on TikTok recently, so check me out. Chat with me
nice
there.
Segue.
I stare at our plants for like an hour every day. I just like stare at them and count all the jalapenos that we're growing. We'll spend time eating and sitting on the couch.
Just go with the flow, kind of. Nothing definitive.
It's very chill. Yeah. Like weekends, we often clean, or Abrar cleans, because you have that motivation.
Really
so
clean.
When we're able to,
yeah,
is basically how it works. But there's no obligations, and like there's no obligation to cook for either of us. There's no obligation to clean. It's just kind of just chill.
Stay chill,
like chill, do what's good for you in
exactly.
the moment.
Take
like
care
what
of
do
yourself.
You need to do? Do you need to book appointments? Do you need to send emails? Like do it, but take a break.
Exactly. Just take care of yourself.
Yeah. We're on a new thing that's recording, but we should continue. Favorite shared meal?
I think it would be pizza.
Pizza and chicken wings. There's this place that we order from, and they have cheese bread, and it's
really
so
good. They also like send us like little notes now, because we order from there so much. It's like the best movie, we'll get it tonight.
For veganism, we're bad vegan. And if you check out on my Instagram, I post about my food, and you'll see that I do some like vegan and vegetarian meals sometimes, but we do eat
really
like,
good.
We try and balance, oh thank you. We try and balance like not eating too much meat, A, because of the animals, but B, we feel like shit when we do. So do you think either one of you will convert?
For me, like religion doesn't really, it's not something that dictates my life. I was born in a Muslim family, and there's obviously cultural and traditional things that I have taken from them. It's always going to be a part of me, but I don't let it dictate my life. When it comes to like building relationships and living your life, I don't feel that it should be a barrier to anything. If you want to be religious, I feel that it should be adding to your life. And if it's creating any kind of like barrier to your life, then you probably should be rethinking that. I know that's controversial, but.
So I come from a Jewish family, and I actually did a 23andMe, which we're going to get your results.
Yeah.
We don't have his results yet, but we're excited. If you want to see mine, I actually did a YouTube video. I'll just link it here. For me, I come from a Jewish family, and like, you know, there's certain things. I really like certain holidays because, you know, you get together and you get to eat, and I've made you like latkes before.
So good.
And he likes when I sing the blessing, like when we light the candles for Hanukkah.
Yeah.
Like we both just respect each other's religion. I remember we did something.
For Eid, like, we got like food, like a lot of like desi, like brown food, which was great.
Yeah.
It was pretty spicy, but it was great.
Oh yeah, so do I think that I would convert? I don't feel like we need to both be the same religion. Kind of like marriage, I don't feel like we need to constantly have this title of like being united, being one. Like, you're my partner, you can be of any religion, you know, like, just respects me and exactly. I respect you, and like neither of us really let.
Because you could be religious too, and it still wouldn't matter.
I just don't want to push that on you. Exactly. That's the thing.
Just be a nice human being. I feel that's
like being respectful.
Yeah.
What kind of things do you argue about?
You know, arguing is not necessarily a bad, like a bad negative word, right?
Yeah, like sometimes we do get frustrated with each other.
Yeah, and that happens. Sometimes I'll do something a certain way, and you'll be like, oh, do it this way. I'm like, because I'm so, like, we are, as human beings, set in our ways, right? And it's hard to change that sometimes.
And it's hard for me to change, like, not telling someone to do something. Exactly. Like, sometimes I'll be like, why are you doing it that way? You should be doing it this way. And that's something that I try to work on. You know what I mean? Yeah, you're just like, Lori, I know what you're trying to do. You're like, I'm going to do it the way that I want to do it.
Yeah.
Okay, so when we get frustrated, it's usually because I meant something and he thought I meant something else, or vice versa.
It's just miscommunication.
Miscommunication, exactly. Exactly. So we try and just be open and honest, and it's like, okay, I'm frustrated. Why am I frustrated? Like, I thought that you were saying this because you were pissed at me. And you'll be like, no, like, I actually meant it like this. And then,
exactly,
then we sort of resolve it.
You just have to communicate what you're trying to say and just say it.
Just say it. So what do you like best about each other?
I mean, there's a lot of things. I'm pretty open-minded, and I've always have been. It's just the way that we were brought up. You kind of showed me that there's a different way to, like, you know, look at life. And I think if I hadn't met you, it would have been kind of like a life wasted. Not wasted in that sense, but in the sense that, like, you just changed my life, basically.
So what I like best about you is that you taught me what unconditional love actually looks like. I was told that I was always unconditionally loved, but it didn't really feel like that sometimes. And from the beginning, you've just like unconditionally accepted me and validated me. You just showed me that like the unconditional love that you had for me, why can't I do that myself? Like, that's what I really started to learn. And that's really what catapulted my recovery, to be honest, is realizing that I can be my number one cheerleader, just like you have been for me. Because you saw me at my lowest.
And, yeah.
You know.
You have to love yourself.
You have to turn it towards you. But yeah. I didn't know that even existed. Right. My recovery is embedded in who I am. It's part of my identity. And like, so you've influenced my being, I guess. So
that's right.
Yeah, no, you're great. How would you feel if Lori made more money than you?
Oh, I'd be so happy. Yeah. Money is not really a thing that should matter in a relationship. Obviously, you need it. You need money.
Like, in capitalistic world, right? You need to have money.
Exactly. I just feel that the money is the easy part. Like, and there's a lot of privilege when I say that.
I was just going to say, yeah.
It's a lot of, like, it's a very privileged statement, but that is my experience.
Money has come and gone for us, and we've kind of been lucky in that way that... Yeah, that, you know, you've been able to find a good job and that, you know, I worked in the past. Yeah, there's really no, we don't have like gender roles specifically. No. Like, you know, he does more of the dishes and like the laundry than I do. And, you know, I do the cooking.
It's also
because
balanced,
I like to.
You, I'm sorry to cut you off. No. Like, sometimes you will be doing more.
Sometimes I will do more. It's basically like we just make up where the other person is. You know, if one person doesn't feel okay, then the other one's like, don't worry, then I'll kind of cover this for you.
Like, if you're doing something, don't do it because you're expecting somebody else to, the other person to be doing it again. Like,
yeah.
You're just doing it because you can do it.
We don't want to build up resentment.
Expectations.
Expectations and those gender roles. Men might be like, oh, I don't want my partner, my wife, my girlfriend or whatever to make more than me because that's kind of like emasculating. And I've heard and seen that somewhere.
It's so funny.
Like, because I think from my understanding, some men do feel that way, which I guess is why they ask that question,
true.
Right?
Yeah.
When I think about that, it's like, is it expected that you earn more than me? No. It's that we both just do our part in whatever way that means
benefits and betters the entire canvas. It makes the canvas a little bit better.
Makes our life more enjoyable.
Exactly.
Do you plan to have kids?
I don't think I'm ready right now. I feel that like kids are a big responsibility.
Yeah.
And you need to have a valid reason. Like, it's not just because it's expected of you to have kids.
Just because everyone has kids.
Exactly. Or that like you need something to kind of take care of to get that goal in life. Like, you should be living for yourself first. I'd rather adopt. There's already too many people in like a finite amount of resources, right?
Yeah, we know what the world is, like overpopulated.
So might as well help somebody and provide them with a chance that they might not have gotten. Yeah, I'm open to anything. Like, it's more of a decision, but that's the way that I'm thinking currently. It can change.
And that's kind of how I think as well, too. You know, having a kid is a huge responsibility, whether you're adopting or otherwise, like just raising a child is so critical. And I want to be in the right state of mind to kind of be able to offer them what a baby or a child would mm-hmm. need. Whereas right now I'm focusing more on myself. Exactly. And like, I don't feel pressured to have a baby or for us to biologically produce children ourselves. Like, sure, it would be beautiful to have little babies, yeah, cool. you know, like just kind of see what we create. And who knows, maybe someday we might decide that. We also might decide, like, maybe you can have a baby and you can adopt. Yeah. Or who knows, because I'm really open to the adoption thing.
It's pretty cool.
The question is, what have you learned from the other person? But I feel like we've answered that. Okay, would you have any like final things to say, I guess?
I would just say that we try to live life as honestly as possible. And not be... Yeah, I think we just live... I think living authentically... I think that's one of the things that I might not have added before.
Mm-hmm.
I do try to say what I mean in a lot of different situations, but... not all the time, which I feel that now I've started to do, and I think that's one of the things that it's happened because of you. Because I see, because it takes a lot of courage. Well, I don't even do it, like, you do it on a platform that's global. So that takes a different kind of courage, yeah. as opposed to what I just have to do it in front of a couple of people, right?
No, but you do hard work. Like, we value each other's work and contributions.
Exactly. Like, value is not just how much you can contribute monetary, like, in terms of money or... value can be in a lot of different ways. I think
to everyone can make the world a better place.
Exactly, that's value.
Yeah.
There we go. That's a good definition.
I always believed really that life was always about output and creating, and I always wanted to work with people and help people, and so I was always putting energy out into the world. And I think you've taught me how to balance that with like bringing in like that calming self-care, validation, mm-hmm. unconditional self-love, that nourishing inward, as so that I can actually exactly like, you can't pour from an empty cup.
No,
you taught me that, so
I'm glad.
You have such an interesting perspective on life, and you know, mine is different, but we have so many overlaps.
And I'm just growing each day, is what I would say. I'm not static. It's not every day that you're obviously growing, but I feel the general trend is I'm evolving more.
So those were good questions. Should we cut it here, I guess?
Sure.
Okay, well, thanks for asking all those amazing questions, and leave questions below if you actually have some, because we can always do another Q&A, build up some questions, do another one, and feel free to ask away, and subscribe, and like, and all the classic stuff that you know that I'm going to say right now. And do you have an outro?
No, I do not. I was just going to say subscribe, and... I was gonna say resubscribe.
Right? Like, I have no idea what to say when it goes outro. I'm like,
Instagram.
TikTok. Yeah, not sorry, love Lori. And just being really honest and authentic. And I think that's the way to go. That's how we live. And it's made our lives infinitely better. Yeah. All right, that's perfect. Bye.
See ya. If Butters wants to go make money, he can too.
And I was like, thinking about Bezos eating chicken. Excuse me.